up, guys? It's your boy, Barca Boy 103. Today, we're going to be reacting to Barcelona news over the past 24 hours. We have some absolutely huge topics to talk about. Firstly, Umtiti and Pjanic being given the letter of freedom by Juan Laporta. Trincao joins Wolves on loan for the rest of next season. Junior Firpo currently in the UK to finalize his move to Leeds United. Collado going to come into the first team to replace Trincao. AC Milan and Shinan Felipe continue this summer. And finally, La Liga will not adjust the salary cap in order to help Barcelona renew the contract of Leo Messi. But before we get into it, make sure you guys smash that like button. Let's try to get the 200 likes on this video. It'll be very much appreciated. And of course, don't forget to subscribe down below if you haven't already. And let's get into it. Before we get into this video is sponsored by the One Football app. It's an absolutely brilliant football app that I've been using now for the past few years. It's the best in my opinion. It has everything you need. Breaking news, transfer news, videos. You have all the matches in the top 5 leagues in one spot, or you can even add more leagues. I believe it has 160 different leagues. And also, you can follow your favorite football team. Of course, for me, it's going to be Barcelona. You can have, you know, predictions. It tells you the next games. You have news about it as well. You have a nice little place where you can see all the tables for Champions League, Copa del Rey, Super Cup, La Liga. You can have the squad list as well. You can see all the first team players of Barcelona and some of the Barcelona B players as well. Nice little spot for transfers as well, for everything that's linked to just Barcelona. And during the match, there is live voting of the man the match. But what I love about this app the most is when we score, it tells you who assists, it tells you if it's a penalty or an own goal. Some apps don't do that. It's absolutely brilliant. Of course, it has full-time stats as well, offside, possession. It also has news on La Liga, transfers on La Liga, and stats as well, top scorer, assists, red cards, yellow cards. This is by far the best football app out there, and the best part is it's free. So top link in the description down below. Give it a go. You won't be disappointed.
Let's start with the biggest news over the past 24 hours, and that is that Francisco Trincao has joined Wolves on loan for the rest of the season. Official, Barcelona and Wolverhampton Wanderers have reached an agreement for the loan move of Francisco Trincao. It will be a season-long loan and Wolves will have to pay his entire salary. There's also a non-mandatory purchase option. And The Athletic have come out saying that Wolves' option to buy Trincao from Barcelona at the end of next season will be around 29 million euros. So pretty much that option to buy is what we paid for Trincao 1 year ago. And I think, to be honest, this is going to be a good move for him going to Wolves, pretty much Portugal FC in the Premier League. Jorge Mendes doing this deal as well. And by the way, no one knew about this again. Juan Laporta, what he's done keeping the media out of everything has been absolutely fantastic. There is not a single report before this was officially announced. Not a single report from anyone. No one credible, no one not credible, nothing. He has done this again, Juan Laporta, keeping the media quiet and making things as he goes along. I tell you what he's done has been absolutely fantastic. And this move for Trincao is going to be good as well. Going to go to Wolves in the Premier League. He can easily bet into the team because it's pretty much all entire Portuguese team. Also, he speaks very good English as well. You know, talk with the English lads there. So Trincao has joined Wolves on loan with an option to buy for next season. And there are reports coming out saying that if Trincao does well, Wolves will buy him 100%. So watch out for that. Trincao is going on loan for the next season. They're going to pay his entire salary. So that's, you know, 100k off the wage bill. And he will be playing in the Premier League next season. Now, you might be wondering who's going to come in and replace Trincao in the first team. To be honest, I don't think we need a replacement because we already have 6 attackers. But Alberto Rojas come out saying that the Barcelona B captain Alex Collado will take Trincao's place in the first team next season. Now, to be honest with you, I don't think Collado will stay that long. I think he'll play maybe the first few games the preseason, then go out on loan as well. We already have 6 attackers: Messi, Aguero, Depay, Griezmann, Ansu Fati, and Ousmane Dembele. Those are going to be the 6 forwards next season. Of course, Dembele and Ansu are kind of injured, so maybe you want to keep Koyal just in case. If he does stay for the upcoming season, I think it will be very, very likely he'll go out on loan in January, similar to what happened with Garcia Aligna last season. But as of right now, Alex Collado will come in to replace Trincao in the first team. A player that won't be doing the preseason this summer and won't be a first teamer as well is Junior Firpo. And there are reports coming in from The Athletic saying that Junior Firpo is currently in England as he's prepared to complete a permanent move to Leeds United. The deal will be worth around 15 million euros plus variables, with the official announcement like to take place this week. So Junior Firpo right now is in the UK doing his quarantine after a few days to do some COVID-19 tests. If they'll come back negative, all good. He'll go to Leeds United, do his medical test, and then the announcement will be made official. So expect that to happen this week. Leeds United will officially announce a new signing of Junior Firpo from FC Barcelona. But a Barcelona player's future that is currently in doubt is Felipe Coutinho, coming in from Marca. They've come out saying that Coutinho's exit will not be easy because of the Brazilian's high salary, but Milan's interest could open the door for the player's departure to the Italian club, where he can benefit from the financial and tax benefits enjoyed by the players there. So AC Milan could be a very, very good and strong destination for Coutinho. Of course, there the taxes are very, very good. That's why Ronaldo went there to Juventus. But again, Barcelona are desperate to get rid of Coutinho because of his high wages, currently on 400k a week. And there are also reports coming out saying that if he goes out on loan, they want the other club to pay at least half of his wages. So if Coutinho does go out on loan this summer to, you know, Leicester City, Everton, Arsenal, AC Milan, Barcelona want that other team to pay at least 200k a week for him. And that could prove to be very, very difficult. But right now, Coutinho is injured with either for him to fully recover from his injury. Then once he's fully recovered, play some preseason game with Barcelona, the interest will start to pick up. But I do believe that Coutinho will be leaving the club this summer. But two players who are said to be leaving the club 100% this summer is Milan Pjanic and also Samuel Umtiti. We talked about in yesterday's transfer video the big news from Mundo Deportivo saying that Barcelona will release Milan Pjanic and Samuel Umtiti. First coming in Fernando Polo from Mundo Deportivo. He came out saying that last Tuesday when Barcelona terminated Fernandez's contract, they also contacted Umtiti and Pjanic. Both don't fit Ronald Koeman's plans and the club wants to save on their salary. Samuel Umtiti did not accept the club's proposal from the outcast. He wants to convince Ronald Koeman and his priority remains to continue at Barcelona. French clubs Lyon and Marseille have asked about his situation. Milan Pjanic, before accepting it, wants to wait to explore the transfer market to find a way out by either a permanent transfer or a loan move. And Juventus and Inter Milan have been interested, but France say that PSG also want him. But the departure policy will not end with just Umtiti and Pjanic. Barcelona's message is clear that there will be more players who oppose to leave. They will grant the letter of freedom. And if they don't accept the letter of freedom, they will be sent to the stands for the entire season. Barcelona want to get rid of these players quickly to comply with the La Liga financial fair play rule to undertake further operations and also be able to make Messi's renewal official ASAP. And Ronald Koeman wants to start the preseason with the players who are in his plans. And Matteo Morito, one of the top journalists in the world, has come out confirming this, saying that as already advanced by Fernando Polo from Mundo Deportivo, it is true that Barcelona offered the letter of freedom to Samuel Umtiti and Milan Pjanic, but they both have not accepted yet. So pretty much this is the story. Barcelona have offered Samuel Umtiti and Pjanic to leave for free this summer, saying, here, you know what? We don't even want you anymore. Just go for free, find your club, and just move on. Right now, Umtiti has said, no, I want to stay, and convince Ronald Koeman. I mean, bloody hell. We'll talk about them individually in a few seconds, but I just want to talk about overall the situation. Pjanic said, you know what? Let me try to find a club first, and if I can't find a club, then I'll accept that letter of freedom. But the main thing to take out from this is that Barcelona are willing to lose Umtiti and Pjanic for free. And remember, 1 year ago, we paid $60 million for Milan Pjanic. $60 million. And next year, he's leaving for free. I mean, that's... it's just a big shock to me. The Pjanic one, I think, is a big shock because we can easily sell him in the market for at least 10 or 15 million. But Umtiti makes perfect sense. No one wants him. He's on 250k a week. But again, the most important thing that Fernando Polo said, that if they don't accept the letter of freedom or don't leave the club this summer, they will be sent to the stands for the entire season. So they will both be frozen out of the club if they don't leave the club this summer. And also, there are more terminations to come as well. So watch out for this. Juan Laporta is doing an absolute overhaul, a huge rebuild at the club right now. And the first two to suffer are Umtiti and Pjanic. Let's now discuss each player on an individual basis. First coming in about Samuel Umtiti from Fernando Polo from Mundo Deportivo. He's come out saying that Umtiti prioritizes staying at Barcelona because he feels that his physical condition has improved, but Barcelona do want to get rid of him this summer. The player does not rule out leaving out on loan if a project from another team convinces him. Now, Juan Marti from Sport has come out with a huge report on Umtiti. He's come out saying that Barcelona contemplate unilaterally rescinding Umtiti's contract. Similar to what they did with Mateus Fernandez, the club is fed up with Umtiti's stance. If he does not try to find a way out, Barcelona will dismiss him and the case will go to FIFA. In this particular situation at hand, Barcelona would have no intention to pay Umtiti's wages of 16 million gross for 2 years. That's why the trial could be held. So Juan Laporta is ready to go to court with FIFA to trial for Samuel Umtiti's departure at the club. I mean, bloody hell. I'm getting goosebumps just thinking about this, man, because the situation is very, very clear. Barcelona want to get rid of Umtiti, but they don't want to pay his entire wages of 16 million gross for the next 2 years. So if Umtiti does not accept a letter of freedom or does not reduce his wages, Barcelona will terminate his contract completely and also not pay him, which means that this will go to court. Oh my goodness. So Barcelona's plan pretty much is to take him to the court. That way they have to pay less of that 16 million euros. If they go to court, he'll probably end up paying maybe 9, 10, 8, something like that. So pretty much in the long term, it would favor Barcelona. I mean, oh my god, Umtiti, are you freaking serious, bro? Just cut, man. Just cut. Like, this is not that serious. You're not like a big player. You're not a big time player. You took the chance with your knee at the World Cup. And now you screwed it up. I see you on Instagram every single day. Oh, yeah, I'm working hard. This report's coming out saying that, oh, Barcelona disappointed because Umtiti's working hard now. Not for the past few years. The past few years, he's been really, really lazy. That's why he's been injured a lot. But now this summer, he's working very hard. They wanted this, you know, 2 years ago. It's like Umtiti, man. Too little, too late, man. Just get the hell out of here. There are also reports coming in from Luis Rojo from Marca. He's come out saying that Umtiti just wants to do the preseason. Give him a chance. He wants one more chance to do the preseason. If he fails, he will go out on loan. That's what Luis Rojo is coming out saying right now as I'm recording this video. If that's the case, I mean, might as well do that than go to court with FIFA and Umtiti. So we'll see what happens. Right now, Umtiti just wants to do the preseason with the club, get one more chance to impress Ronald Koeman. If not, he will agree to going out on loan. But again, the club don't even want to loan him. They just want to get rid of him at this point. As you can see from the statement, the club is fed up with Umtiti's stance. So watch out for Umtiti this summer. 100% he will be leaving the club this summer. The question is how. Termination of contract, a loan move, or maybe even a player sale or a swap deal. Now, the individual situation of Pjanic is a little bit different because, of course, he is open to leaving the club. And Xabi Lemos has come out saying that the script has changed regarding Samuel Umtiti. The club have offered him to go out on loan, and it seems that he has accepted it. Now, to unravel the situation, Barcelona have offered Umtiti the letter of freedom as well as Milan Pjanic. In both cases, Umtiti and Pjanic must now negotiate the final agreement. In the case of Umtiti, it's already amortized, but for Pjanic, it would lead to a loss of 45 million euros in the account. This is why I was so shocked for Pjanic getting the letter of freedom of Juan Laporta as well. I could not believe it. That's 45 million euros just down the drain. Like, just might as well just put the money in the toilet and just flush it at this point, because it's just, like, you can sell Pjanic if you sell him for the bare minimum of, say, 10 or 15 million euros. There's clubs that would pay that. I think Inter Milan would 100% pay that. PSG, maybe because of the beef that we had, they wouldn't really do it. Juventus could possibly do it. But I think there's ways for Pjanic to leave the club. Even Chelsea maybe could pay a little bit of a fee for him. But giving him the letter of freedom is a big move by Juan Laporta. But in the end, Pjanic is going to comply with the club. He won't cause us any problems. He will leave 100%. And that will free up 400k off the wage bill, by the way, because he's on 400 grand a week, or 350k. But, like, I don't know what was going through Bartomeu's mind giving a 30-year-old 350k a week. But anyways, that's the most important thing. That's why Barcelona are doing this, to get rid of that wage bill. Umtiti and Pjanic together make around 700k a week. That's just cleared off the wage bill and going straight to Leo Messi's contract, which we'll talk about in a few minutes. The rebuild of Barcelona is starting to pick up some pace. I told you guys, just wait for the transfer window to open. It's now been open for about 5 days, and we've seen some quick movement. Didier Firpo has been out, Trincao out on loan, Pjanic and Umtiti about to leave the club, Conrad has left. Barcelona and Juan Laporta are picking up the speed now for the departures. You know why? Because Ronald Koeman wants to know about the same squad for the preseason that's coming up in 2 weeks. So when we come to the preseason in 2 weeks, we will have a good indication of what the squad will look like for next season. But again, this is only the beginning. I think Pjanic will leave the club 100% and give us no troubles. But Umtiti's case is going to be very, very different. Now, as I just mentioned, one of the main reasons why Juan Laporta is releasing Samuel Umtiti and Milan Pjanic is because they make room on the wage bill so we can finally finalize Messi's contract renewal. And Edu Polo from Mundo Deportivo has come out saying that Mateo Alemany met with Javier Tebas a few days ago. Barcelona wanted to know if the Liga salary limit regulation could be made flexible, seeking to find a solution for Messi's contract renewal. But Javier Tebas insisted that exceptions won't be made. I mean, Javier Tebas is one of the biggest hypocrites I've ever seen. This Madrid fan comes out saying that, oh, Messi's the best player in the world, the best player of all time. He's the face of La Liga. Yet when Barcelona want to renew his contract and need just a little bit of help, you say no. I mean, if Messi leaves La Liga, by the way, there is no damn way that outside fans will be watching La Liga. No way. I'm only watching La Liga because I'm a Barcelona fan. If I had a choice, I wouldn't watch La Liga. And he's saying that, look, we don't want to help you in any way, shape, or form. This is your problem. Figure it out. I mean, come on. We're not asking for a miracle here. We're just asking for just a little bit of an adjustment of the salary cap. And you're saying no. I mean, piss off, mate. This is why we have to release Pjanic and Umtiti, because we need to renew Messi's contract right now, ASAP. Like Fernando Polo said, Barcelona want to renew his contract ASAP-erino, as soon as possible. And that's why they have taken drastic measures to release Pjanic and Umtiti to renew Messi's contract. And by the way, I still see a lot of people in my comments saying, oh, Messi's not going to renew, he's going to go to PSG or City. Look at Barcelona. They're still tweeting about Messi, and he's not even a Barcelona player. You see the Barcelona official Twitter account and official Instagram as well, tweeting videos of Messi's free kick against Ecuador. By the way, what a fantastic free kick. And people still tell me, oh, Messi's going to go to PSG or City just waiting for an offer. He's staying at the club. The question is, how long is he going to stay as a free agent, and also when are we going to renew his damn contract? It looks like it's going to be happening very, very soon with the letter of freedom given to Pjanic and Umtiti in order to free up that wage bill. So that was my reaction to the Barcelona news over the past 24 hours. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you leave a like, and of course, leave your thoughts down below in the comments on everything we discussed. But the main thing I want to know, especially about Trincao joining Wolves on loan, what do you think about that? And secondly, what do you think about the letter of freedom being given to Umtiti and Pjanic? And of course, do not forget to subscribe down below as well. And I'll see you guys next time on the channel. Take care and Forza Barca.